Thank you very much for the introduction. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Klaus Beiter at Vector Informatik in Stuttgart. I'm responsible for the development of the diagnostic authoring tools Candela Studio and ODX Studio, and also for customer services. It's a pleasure for me to be here today and to have the opportunity to talk about our diagnostic solution, about our cooperation with Toyota, and about trends in diagnostics we see today. I will start with our diagnostic solution. It consists of tools and services, and on the tool side, we have tools for the complete development cycle of ECU diagnostics. On the right-hand side of the V model, we have Candela Studio as a diagnostic authoring tool to create diagnostic specifications. ODX Studio is a pure ODX editor. The specifications we create in Candela Studio are stored in the machine-readable XML file, the CDD file, and this gives us the possibility to have this data processed in the downstream tool chain. At the bottom of the V model, we have the diagnostic relevant AUTOSAR software components and the corresponding configuration tools on the right hand side with a pure diagnostic tester Indigo. Canoe also comes with diagnostic functionality if you lay the CDD file. Canoe Diva is a tool for the automated generation of test cases and the execution of these test cases in Vector, in Canoe. And VFlash is our flash tool. We are active in tool development, also in standardization groups. And we are supporting car projects all over the world since many years, and therefore we have built up a lot of know-how in diagnostics area, and we support customers also by services. We can adapt our tools to the environments and requirements of our customers. We support in the creation of specifications, diagnostic specification test, or flash test specifications, and also do reviews of the specifications. We also develop software outside of our products, for example, data converters, or also security related software and cryptography based software for diagnostics. Due to the standardization activities and experience, we also support in the introduction of the relevant technologies. And if you want to build up the relevant know-how, we offer trainings for the technologies and tools. It's important for us that on the Japanese market, we have colleagues here at Vector Japan with excellent know-how of the technologies, of the customer situations. And in this project in Japan, our colleagues at Vector Japan normally collect the requests for the requirements from the customers, and the implementation is done at Vector Informatik in Stuttgart, which ensures compliance to our tool chain. I will now come to our cooperation with Toyota, which started a few years ago. And basically due to two decisions at Toyota, one to introduce a machine-readable format for specifications, which has the advantage that tools can automatically process these specifications. And Toyota therefore selected Candela Studio. And the second decision was to move to AUTOSAR software architecture, and precondition for that was also introduction of UDS. And in order for the ECU development according to AUTOSAR, a tool chain that supports checks, data conversions and so on is necessary in order to handle the complexity. I have it on this slide, and the diagnostic relevant part is on the left bottom side. You can see Candela Studio. And the CDD file is the input for the DaVinci configurator for the configuration of the diagnostic base software DCM, DEM. And you can see Candela Studio is the file to describe the basic software for diagnostics, and therefore I have this slide explaining a bit of Candela Studio. The Candela file is the specification of an ECU's diagnostic functionality in the ECU and also the tester communication. Each CDD file, we have one CDD file for each CDU, and these files are derived from the template. The template collects the ISO standards, the OEM-specific diagnostic specification, and also general diagnostic data, which are applicable for all ECUs. So the template ensures the compliance to the standard and to the OEM specific diagnostic requirements. Creating a CDD file is similar to creating a Word file based on a template. The concept guides the user to the creation of the specification. Candela Studio is designed for ECU developers, data format know-how of ODX, DEXT, or other formats is not required. And the Toyota template is created by Vector and maintained by Vector and also verified in the complete toolchain. Now, as we have the CDD file, because it is required for the base software configuration, we can look for other opportunities to take benefit of the CDD file. And one is that, for example, Canoo is available on many development PCs. And therefore, loading a CDD file in Canoo makes also Canoo a diagnostic tester. Also, this is also true for Canapé. And Indigo, our diagnostic tester, is also parameterized by CDD file. Another option is ODX. If you have a CDD file and Candela Studio, pressing a button, you can generate ODX files. ODX is today well established for the parameterization of diagnostic testers in production and aftermarket. In ODX is typically a situation that you have an ODX authoring guideline that describes the ODX structure for your processes. And Vector also supported Toyota in creating such an ODX authoring guideline, and the Candela Studio ODX export of also is compliant to the Toyota ODX authoring guideline. And Toyota took a decision also to use ODX or to generate ODX using Candela Studio for test systems. And there are more possibilities to take advantage of the CDD file. The generation of test cases and automation of test execution is an important trend in testing. The system supplier needs extensive tests to support development as well as regression and release tests. Automotive also, OEMs also have extended testing for the integration of the system. And Canoo Diva is a tool used also for usage at supplier and OEM side, and it supports the automatic creation of test cases and their execution. It basically consists of a configurator with a dedicated user interface, a generator that gets as an input the CDD and ODX file and creates the test modules, which will be then executed in the runtime library of Canoo. The test results are written to a test report and can be analyzed in the report analyzer. The standard Canoe Diva can also be extended to OEM or customer-specific requirements. The standard Canoe Diva supports the relevant protocols, UDS, KWP, OBD, and other OEM-specific protocols on many bus systems. And we have test generation for protocol validation, which means addressing and timing, which is described in the CDD file, also the processing of valid and invalid requests in the ECU, the assignment of the services to session and security levels, and also data types and value limits. Then on application level, it is possible, for example, to check a write service by the corresponding read service or also by XCP and CCP access to the corresponding variables. Combined with a VT system, it is also possible to provoke errors and to check if the ECU reports them correctly. And last but not least, it's possible to map the test cases to requirements and to check the correct fulfillment of the requirements. As I said, it's possible to extend, and we have created an extension for the Toyota UDS specification covering the Toyota UDS services and also transport protocol aspects, and also for the diagnostic protocol before UDS, a test extension is available. And the normal Canoe Diva comes with an English test report, and for Toyota we have also Japanese language test record. And Toyota today highly recommends suppliers to use Canoe Diva for the testing. Summary of my first part of the presentation. We have, based on the CDD file in the middle, which is derived from the CDD file, we have at supplier side the possibility to configure the basis software and do the Diva testing. Same is possible also at OEM side, and additionally ODX can be generated as input for diagnostic testers, for example in production and the service area. So the tools cover all relevant use cases for diagnostic development. I would like to now to shift to trends in diagnostics. I will have one part about the AUTOSAR diagnostic extract template, and then a second part about remote diagnostic solutions. So diagnostic extract template is related to AUTOSAR development process. And the motivation for this new file format is presented quickly, because before this format there was no standard available. There were many tool chains, there were many processes, and former attempts to use ODX or ECUC failed because ODX is missing features and ECUC was not designed as a data exchange format. And therefore, AUTOSAR released a diagnostic extract template, which we call DEXT, first in the version 4.2.1. And this is a file format with focus on basic software configuration for AUTOSAR Classic, as well for the new AUTOSAR Adaptive platform. And according to the AUTOSAR compliance, it supports UDS, OBD, and J1939 diagnostic protocols. It is designed as a data exchange format between OEM and suppliers. Today we see that the AUTOSAR standardization is in an evolution process, and also the text format will be released with each version, and there will be future changes. And what we also see is that OEMs today use different versions of the AUTOSAR and therefore the text format. On this slide, I have displayed the differences between the different formats. ODX focuses on the tester with also variant coding and flashing. The CDD file is only relevant for the diagnostic communication, but it supports tester parameterization, base software configuration, and also a diagnostic validation, for example, in DISA. And the new format text is here, the intersection. It has its focus on the basic software configuration. Today, the OEMs start to use the text for the exchange of BSV, also base software configuration. And an important aspect is that you get biggest benefit from the text if it is related to the system description. And at Vector, we have a designed solution to establish such a connection to the AUTOSAR system descriptions. Typically, you start with the collection of the diagnostic requirements. For example, you have the requirement to get the window position as a readable DIT. And this requirement can be imported via CSV file into Candela Studio. And the diagnostic communication designer in Candela Studio typically assigns DID number to that requirements. And on the other hand, the data for this DID must be modeled in the AUTOSAR model. And for example, if you use prevision for the diagnostic requirements, you can also use it for the system description, and you can add this information to the requirement, for example, the scaling and the access of the related variables in the system model. And this, an extract of the system description can be stored from prevision, and it is this file that afterwards can be synchronized with the Candela Studio description. This works because both paths have the same source and there is a common ID, and therefore a synchronization mechanism is possible. In the sync step, the placeholder in the Candela file is replaced by the real modeling, and also the source in the application is stored in Candela Studio. And this gives Candela Studio the possibility to export a diagnostic extract that is connected to the system description. And both files are then the input for the configuration of the RTE and also of the basic software. I would like now to switch the topic another time and come to remote diagnostic solutions. And I think there are many use cases for such solutions. Think of a problem in your production plant, maybe in overseas, that only can be used by a technical expert from the development department. If an engineer has to travel, this you will lose time and you will spend money for it. Other scenario is issue in a test drive, the same, or issue in an after-sales garage that cannot be used locally, or also issues with integrated components, maybe from car corporations. Common to all of these use cases or these examples is that if you don't have a remote solution, you will lose time and you will spend money. And I will show you now different scenarios for remote diagnostic solutions. First is Indigo Remote. Indigo is a pure diagnostic tester. It is self-configuring, vehicle-oriented, and it is available for the relevant diagnostic protocols and bus systems. And Indigo, normally as non-remote solution, is connected via network interface to the vehicle. I will show you now how we can also have Indigo as remote solution. And for this, we replace the Indigo tool by a so-called Indigo access point, which is connected to the vehicle. And a technician, for example, in the garage, is connecting via the access point, which is available on SPC or on a VN8810 hardware, to the Indigo remote server. And by the connection, he gets session ID and the password. And with these credentials, he invites an expert also to connect. And the expert with the connections, with the credentials, also connects to the Indigo remote server, establishes the connection to the vehicle, and he is working with the Indigo tester from a distance with the vehicle and has exactly the same possibilities as if it is connected locally with the vehicle. So this is a plug-and-play ready solution for remote diagnostics. Another option we offer is the upgrade of an existing test system to remote functionality. And this is presented on this slide. Precondition is a test system that is based on a PDU API implementation. And this precondition is fulfilled by many test systems because this is also the typical architecture standardized in ISO 22900. So what you have to do is to replace the PDU API library of your tester by the DPDU remote API library of Vector. And then the connection to the vehicle is very similar to the Indigo remote case. You connect to the Vector Cloud, and with a session ID and password, you can connect to the vehicle, and you have the same options as if your tester is connected locally at your vehicle. So now we have seen two scenarios where the diagnostic functionality still is on the PC at the client side. And I would like to show you now a scenario where the diagnostic communication is shifted to the cloud. Only the representation of the tester remains on the client. The diagnostic communication, interpretation, security, DLL, diagnostic sequences, this all is moved to the what we call diagnostic web services. The connection to the vehicle then is established by a similar mechanism as in the previous cases, for example, using the remote DPDU API. And such an architecture gives you the possibility to design modern diagnostic systems, because an open API allows you to integrate existing systems, such as spare part ordering systems. It's also possible to have user interfaces, browser-based user interfaces, or even mobile interfaces. And last but not least, such a system can feed the field data into a knowledge-based system, which is a precondition for data analysis as, for example, with big data or deep learning approaches. The advantage of such a system is also that a software update of the diagnostic tester functionality, the diagnostic data, security mechanisms can be done in one place. It is a simple mechanism, and customer satisfaction will be increased because you have very short maintenance times with such a solution. And I will come now to VN8810. I will skip this slide because my colleagues on the booth will explain in detail about this solution, and I will come to a summary of the last part of my presentation. I have shown you different approaches for realizing a remote diagnostic system. Which one should be selected depends on your requirements and use cases. Indigo Remote is available as plug-and-play ready solution. The remote DPU API solution is fitting for an update of your existing tester with remote functionality. And the diagnostic web services can be used in order to integrate existing systems as an order part, as a spare part order system. Common to all of these approaches is the fact that the access point is still outside of the vehicle. And the next evolution step would be to move also the access point into the vehicle. This would be a precondition for OTA solutions, such as diagnostics over the air or software update over the air. And we are currently working on these issues, and we will present on the next Vector Congress our results to this to this work. A successful implementation of remote diagnostics and of over-the-air solution requires significant know-how in automotive and IT. Sustainable solution integrates seamlessly the in-vehicle software, the back-end server, and also the traditional PC tools. Vector is looking forward to support you in this topic. And before closing my presentation, I would like to say thank you to Toyota partners for the excellent cooperation. And if you have any questions, please do not hesitate. I'm available now and afterwards also in the breaks. Thank you very much for your attention.